Imagine that suddenly you have no power and you have an electric car. What now? So guys, recently in Portugal, Spain and some parts of France, we had a power outage. So the full grid of electricity went down. So there was no warning, there was nothing. The power just went off and we realized that was not only in our street, in our home, but the full country was off. Nobody knew what happened. Nobody knew how long it will take to restore the power in our homes. So let's talk about EVs on these type of situations. What it is to have an electric car if there is no power at all. Is this something that we need to worry about? Do we have any advantage of having an electric car over an ICE car? So the first question is, can you charge an electric car during a power outage? So the obvious answer is no. In most of the situations, you cannot charge your car. So the home charger without electricity will not work. Of course, there are situations that if you have an off-grid solution with a solar system, you can use the free power of the sun to charge not only the car, but also your house. But these are a very small percentage of people that has these solutions in place. Then, of course, the public stations are not working also. So the charging network is not going to help you in this case because it's going to be off also. So the main advice that I can give you is just consider to have always a 20 to 30% battery in your car for any situation like this. But it is important to say also that these small particular situations where you have an off-grid and a solar system can be in fact an advantage. You still have free power every single day that can be charging your car. So what it is to live with an EV during a power outage? So first, let's say that a battery in an electric car can last days if you just use it for local trips. So if you just need the car to go to a grocery store, to get something, to do some errands, very quick ones, the battery can last days. So in principle, you will not have any problem with an electric car during a power outage like this one that we had. Also, there is one functionality in an EV that is the regeneration. So most of the new EVs do provide regeneration. So if you are driving in cities, driving locally, in principle, the range will even extend to much longer than the normal WLTP range that you have of your car. So for instance, in my case, I do have an Xpeng G6. The range of it is 435. But if I start doing only local drives, city drives, my range will go until almost 550 kilometers. Also, of course, you can precondition battery or even using less AC to save more battery and power. So is there any real advantage of having an electric car in a power outage? Well, some. So for instance, you don't need to go to a gas station to fill your car. So again, if you have an off-grid solution with the sun, a solar system, you can do by your own, be filling your battery every single day without the need of going anywhere. In a gas station, if you have an ICE car, you do have to rely on going to a gas station, to a petrol station, to fill in your car. But those stations probably will not be working also because of the power outage. So, and then, of course, you have some cars that have functionalities that do provide you with more things. For instance, vehicle to load or vehicle to home. These two functionalities do provide you some big advantages if you have an EV. For instance, my Xpeng G6 does have vehicle to load functionality. This means that I can just connect an adapter to the power of the car and it will transform. Instead of me being charging the car can provide energy to some equipment. So in my case, my specific case, we have, for instance, a 3.3 kilowatt power, output power that can be used to provide energy, for instance, to a fridge, to some equipment in your home, so that you can still have some comfort and still can preserve food, for instance, when you have a power outage. There are even other cars, other brands that have functionalities like vehicle to home. You can even power the full home with your car. So giving the example of my car that has a 66 kilowatt battery with the possibility to use vehicle to load, I could connect several equipments to the car during the night, for instance, to provide energy to those equipments, to maintain, for instance, to preserve food with the fridge, to cook the meals, or to give light to the house. I could use the car for days. So imagine that having an off-grid solution with solar panels that could collect energy to provide this energy to the house and also charge the car during the day. And then during the night, using that energy that is in the battery to provide the energy to the house, it's a big, big, big advantage. So it's like having a generator with wheels. So you have not only a car, but also a car that generates power to your home. So it is an advantage. What about the disadvantages? So of course, if it is an electric car, then it needs electricity. So if you don't have an off-grid solution, if you don't have solar panels, if you don't have your own charger, then you have a problem because range will be a problem because you still need to use your car for your drives, your routes, but you don't have anywhere to charge your car. So it is a real problem. So most of the countries where we live do not have any mobile solution to charge your cars. So it is very easy to have a mobile solution to use fuel for ICE cars, but for electricity, it's more complicated. There are some already in place, but they are not very common. And I believe that in a situation like that, it would be impossible to request a service like this. So the grid dependency is real, and we need to be prepared for that. So the question is, how can we be prepared for something like this? Of course, there is no magic solution. So as I mentioned before, there are the off-grid solutions. So if you have a detached house, if you have a solar system, you can have an off-grid solution and then use this power from the sun to charge your car and even provide energy to your home. So this is one solution that it's the best of both worlds. Then, of course, you need to consider the vehicle to load and vehicle to home functionality. Just check if your car, if your brand has this type of functionalities. And if so, just consider on buying the adapter that needs to be on the car so that you can take energy out of it. It's called the discharge adapter that you can take energy from your car to provide that energy to equipments in your home. This will be very important to have. So in terms of conclusion, the question that may arise is, should we be worried about this if we are a owner of an electric car or if we are thinking on getting an electric car? Well, my honest opinion is that no, this is not a common situation, at least in my country. Of course, that you need to take in consideration how the grid, electricity grid in your country is and performs. But in my country, this is not a common situation. Sometimes we do have power outages, but not more than 1 hour or something like that. And that would not be even considered a problem for an electric car. So this is not common. So it's not a real problem at all. Also, electric cars are part of the future. So we just need to adapt to this new future with some new habits, with smart habits and smart thinking on the situation. So to conclude the video, I'm just curious about this. If you were in Portugal, France, and Spain, if you had this problem, what did you felt? Were you worried about this situation? Tell us about it in the comments. Even if you are in a different country, but you had this problem already, or even if you just learned about this and you start thinking on, I have an electric car, what will I do? Just let us know in the comments so that we can discuss a little bit this topic. So guys, thank you very much again for being here. Do like and subscribe the channel if you like this type of content, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.